I give you glory for all you brought me through. And now I'm ready for whatever you want to do. I'm moving forward to follow after you. And now I'm ready for whatever you want to do. Your presence is an open door. We want you, Lord, like never before. Your presence is an open door. So come now, Lord, like never before. And every your grace has been enough, and I'm believing the best is yet to come. The cross before me, my hope on things above, and in you, Jesus, the best is yet to come. Your presence, it's an open door. We want you, Lord, like never before. Your presence is an open door. So come now, Lord, like never before. Oh, my God made me a promise and it won't stop now. I know breakthrough is coming. By faith I see a miracle. My God made me a promise and it won't stop now. Oh,
I would like to share with you a message entitled Step Up to Your Next Level. We are all called by the Lord to continue to grow. When you stop growing, you stop leading. So it is necessary for us to keep growing. You know, when you stop growing, you start dying. So in order for us not to be stagnant, let us continue to be passionate in our pursuit to grow. But I want us to consider that in order for us to step up our next level, number one, we need to ask God to reveal us our present divine assignment. You know, in Acts chapter 9, tells us that Saul has his own pursuit of life, and that is to arrest the believers and drag them to prison. But God has another plan for him. And so in that chapter 9 of Acts, he encountered God. And God revealed to him his present divine assignment. I believe that if the Apostle Paul, in spite of the fact that he was sincerely wrong in his pursuit. Dahil ang akala po niya ay paggagawin niya yon to arrest the believers and drag them to prison, he is doing it for God. Because he has that, of course, traditional knowledge on Judaism. And they don't regard Jesus as the Savior. But praise God that Jesus has considered his sincerity as far as his faith is concerned. And so in that wonderful encounter, the Apostle Paul, which later on called the Apostle Paul, received his divine assignment. Ako po'y naniniwala na tayo pong lahat ay kailangan din po natin malaman ang plano at kalooban ng Diyos para sa atin, sa ating kasalukuyan na buhay. Because if we don't cooperate with our present divine call or assignment from the Lord, we will miss out our next level. And number two that I would like us to consider here is, do not dwell on the past. You know, when we dwell on especially our negative experiences in the past and allow those things to drag us down, it will prohibit us. It will hinder us from stepping to our next level. Kaya nga po doon sa Isaiah 43 verse 18 to 19, sabi po niya, forget the former things. Do not dwell on the past. In verse 19, sabi niya, see, I am doing new things. Now it springs up. Do you not perceive it? I am making a way in the wilderness and streams in the wasteland. He emphasized yung salitang, mga salitang, do not dwell on the past. Bakit po napakahalaga? Because lahat po tayo ay dumadaan ng maraming challenges sa buhay natin. Mas lalo pag tayo po ay sumusunod sa kalooban ng Panginoon, maraming mga dumarating na challenges sa buhay. And there are people who allow those challenges na undermine yung kanilang pursuit in life. Until last time that they are no longer growing because they allow those hurts, pains to somewhat rattle them. But I'm challenging you. If in case you have this personal analysis or evaluation and you perceive that seemingly you are not growing, I would challenge you that ask the Lord to help you, especially for you to experience His healing power so that you will not dwell on the past because ay matanggap mo at malaman mo as you ask the Lord to reveal to you your next assignment or your present assignment upang sa ganon ay magampanan mo sa magitan ng Kanyang tulong. So, do not dwell on the past. Napakalaga po, kapatid. At ikalawa ay, you need to repair your altar. Habang dumadaan ka sa mga sakuna, challenge sa buhay, marami kang mga bagay na kinukonsider sa buhay mo and you became so busy that even you forgot your prayer life. You know, In 1 Kings chapter 18, verse 30 onward, mababasa po natin doon that the prophet Elijah had this encounter. This encounter is all about proving who has true God, kung sino po sa kanila ang may totoo na Diyos. At mababasa po natin dito na first of all, Elijah repaired the altar. and build the altar. Pagkatapos noon, if you continue to study this, fire from heaven came down and consumed their sacrifices, hindi kagaya po nung Baal worshippers. They were so frustrated. But to Elijah, he prevailed because totoo po ang Diyos na kanyang sinasampalatayanan. Now, I am encouraging you so that you would be able to overcome any obstacles in life. At napakalaga that we need to repair our altar. And that is going back to where the Lord called us. You know, I realize as a minister of the gospel that when we neglect our prayer life, we lost power. You know, meron pong mga bagay na hinahanap po natin sa mga buhay po natin. At we need to be reminded that above or else or above everything, we need to consider this, repair your altar. And maybe this is what you are needing today. Ito po ang iyong kailangan ngayon na you need to be reminded that in order for you to step up to your next level, you need to repair your altar. And number four that I would like us to consider as we are now discussing on how we could step to our next level, step up to our next level. Number four is encounter God in your obedience. Encounter God in your obedience. Going back to Acts chapter 9, mababasa po natin doon that right away when the apostle of Paul, he was Saul before, but he became the apostle Paul. When he had that encounter with the Lord, right away, he obeyed the Lord. And that's why in Acts chapter 9, verse 20, sabi po niya rito, immediately in synagogue, he proclaimed Jesus that he is the Son of God. This is how the Apostle Paul encountered God through his obedience as he continued in his obedience unto the Lord. Maraming mga bagay, maraming mga himala na kanyang nararanasan. And I know that we are all we as people of God are entitled to many, many miracles. Well, in fact, yung buhay mo ngayon, yung buhay natin ngayon, is already considered as a miracle because especially if you're a Christian, kung wala po ang grasyan ng Panginoon, it is really impossible for you to become believer in the Lord Jesus Christ. Kaya nga, doon po sa Ephesians chapter 2, verse 8 tells us that our salvation is by grace through faith in Christ Jesus. At habang tayo po ay nagpapatuloy na naglilingkod sa Panginoon, I tell you, we need to believe that God would continue to empower us for our miracles. And last that I would like to share with you in relation to how to step up to our next level, number five is listen and acknowledge your inner voice of faith. There is that inner voice of faith ringing in your heart today. And that will never happen if you will not respond, if you will not listen and respond to it. You know, James tells us that ang pananampalataya po na walang gawa ay patay na pananampalataya. And so, I believe that it is necessary for us to consider or to listen and acknowledge the inner voice of faith. It is the voice, that is the voice of the Holy Spirit deep inside of us. Listen to it, acknowledge it, and act on it. And as we do that, I believe you will experience your next level in your life as believer. So, how to step up to our next level? Number one is ask God to show you your present divine assignment. And number two is do not dwell on the past. Number three, repair your altar. Number four, encounter God in your obedience, as demonstrated in the life of the Apostle Paul. And then number five is listen and acknowledge your inner voice of faith. Why? Revelation tells us that the Spirit of God is speaking to God's people in this generation. And you can do that because there is that assurance deep inside of you that there is that inner voice of faith, the voice of the Holy Spirit. With this, I pray that as you meditate on these words or challenge that I have shared with you, the Holy Spirit will enable you to step up to your next level. Father, I pray that our listeners today, as we all consider this truth that would help us step up to our next level, we ask your guidance, your empowerment, and your enablement. In the mighty name of Jesus we pray, amen and amen. Thank you and God bless.